In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who confounded all the commands of your sacred law upon the love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. Like a stream is the king's heart in the hand of the Lord. Wherever he pleases him, he directs it. All the ways of a man may be right in his own eyes, but it's the Lord who proves heart. Do what is right and just is more acceptable to the Lord than sacrifice. Haughty eyes and a proud heart, the tillage of the wicked is sin. The plans of the diligent are sure of profit, but all rash haste leads certainly to poverty. Whoever makes a fortune by a lying tongue is chasing a bubble over deadly snares. The soul of the wicked man desires evil. His neighbor finds no pity in his eyes. When the arrogant man is punished, the simple are the wiser. When the wise man is instructed, he gains knowledge. The just man appraises the house of the wicked. There is one who brings down the wicked to ruin. He who shuts his ear to the cry of the poor will himself also call and not be heard. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm. Guide me, Lord, in the way of your commands. Guide me, Lord, in the way of your commands. Blessed are they whose way is blameless, who walk in the law of the Lord. Guide me, Lord, in the way of your commands. Make me understand the way of your precepts, and I will meditate on your wondrous deeds. Guide me, Lord, in the way of your commands. The way of truth I have chosen, I have set your ordinances before me. Guide me, Lord, in the way of your commands. Give me discernment, that I may observe your law and keep it with all my heart. Guide me, Lord, in the way of your commands. Lead me in the path of your commands, for in it I delight. Guide me, Lord, in the way of your commands. And I will keep your law continually, forever and ever. Guide me, Lord, in the way of your commands.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are those who hear the word of God and observe it. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The mother of Jesus and his brothers came to him, but were unable to join him because of the crowd. He was told, "Your mother and your brothers are standing outside, and they wish to see you." He said to them in reply, "My mother and my brothers are those who hear the word of God and act on it." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The word of God is living and true, so it is as applicable today as when it was written. By receiving the gifts of God's commands and living accordingly, we become members of the family of God. And now, brothers and sisters, together let us turn our hearts in prayer to our loving Father for the faithful throughout the world. May the Lord increase in us the virtues of faith, hope, and charity. Let us pray to the Lord. For policymakers, may the Holy Spirit inspire them in working for the common good. Let us pray to the Lord. For our parish family, may the Lord strengthen our identity as one family in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, especially for those whom this mass is offered, Franz Herb Rottweiler, Josefa Wojciechowski, Maria Patryka, may the Lord welcome them to the eternal joy of heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father, you never cease to love us. Graciously hear our prayers, which we bring to you through your beloved Son, Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, God, all creation, for your goodness you have seen the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, the work of men's hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, God, for creation, for your goodness, you have seen wine in the offering, fruit of the vine and rock of men's hands, it will become our spiritual being. Sister, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God and the Almighty Father. Receive with favor, Lord, we pray the offerings of your people, that the Lord again profess with devotion of faith. May it be theirs through these heavenly mysteries and through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give it thanks to the Lord our God. It is true, right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise, as without end we are glad.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth, O Lord, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are in the holy, Lord, the fountain of all holiness, make holy, therefore at these days we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving his hands broken and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my God, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving a thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving the thanks that you have kept us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be guided into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread it throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis of Pope and place our bishop and daughter clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, Lord, but died in mercy. Welcome and them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph and Moshe, his spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Zachary, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced with the light, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, and the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours forever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, be thy living, may be thy giving, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with the word. Will him and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, and take away the sins of the world.
The Father Christ.
Let us pray. Gracious, we raise up, O Lord, those you renew, even as they start from